This will hopefully be the story of two transformations. But of course, you never know with cinema en prévu. Well, here is a sculpture that has rearranged itself overnight. However, it still kept the same name and subject matter, which is a different kind of birdcage. So inevitably they drop to a lower energy state that is closer to the ground. However, in this case, I believe that this point has been thrown so far up in the air that it's actually above where the top of the last one was. Anyhow, the bird now hangs facing the museum proper. And so, might be a better rearrangement after all. So, second transformation concerns this. Kind of has the look of a butchered shark or something. But anyway, it's on this very nice old hand truck, which I wish to combine with something else. And here it is, an old oxen yoke. I don't know, something about the old paint job, red and yellow. Seems they should go together somehow, especially on two such elemental items as a hand truck and an oxen yoke. And perhaps it'll give that wood thing in between something of an identity of its own. From looking out our own beautiful front door, we see we've assembled the elements in their new location. Comes with its own natural sound system. There's also, in between, a scene from the Luddite Inquisition. And a concealed Buddha. Wow. Lighting in the daytime. We really go that extra mile for you, viewers. I hope you appreciate this. But I think I'll have my friend the unknown martial artist do the actual assembly. His roof sculpture has stayed up so perfectly. Maybe he's just on a roll.
Well, that's pretty good. Except you can see we can't leave it sticking out in front of the door that much.
So we'll just, I think we can move this a little.
Hey, come here, Mr. Martial Artist. What do you think of that? Oh well, I guess the adjustment was no good. But maybe we could leave it like this. All in all, I much prefer natural transformation. Yeah, this is more like what we wanted. I suppose, like quantum interference, making of false art is best done unobserved. Because when you see, really see, how easily something is done, you tend not to value the results as much as you should. And you have to say, for conceptual art, this is at least a little more than Duchamp did with his first ready-made, or any of them, really.